it's Nightshroud99 again. I'll be doing a review on the Invisible Lego. I'm just joking. I'm actually going to be doing a review on Series 4 Lego collectible minifigures. I got 6 of them, and luckily I didn't get any repeats. Because usually there is like, I think there's like 16 of them. 16. 16 of these figures, and Series 3 I kind of, it really sucked because I went to Toys R Us, got six Series 3 minifigures. I got 3 stupid British Air Force guys, 2 racers, and 1 Blacktron dude. So I was really disappointed in Series 3. And besides, the figures in that one weren't that great, but Series 4 is really nice. And I also picked up a 2-pack for Halo. But first off, I'm not going to show you all at once because you probably just leave. I will show you. The first one I opened was the Wolfman. He is really cool. And of course, Lego being non-violent, they gave a bio for him. Basically, he's a mentally challenged, hairy individual who runs around and digs holes, and you're supposed to laugh at him. Very cruel, if you ask me. He's one of my favorite figures, and one of the ones I wanted. He has reprinted elf hair, but now it's brown. He comes with a little dog bone. Yeah. Next, I opened the Viking. Viking is a really nice figure. Let me move that away. He has a nice printed buckler shield, a hand axe, printed legs, a nice printed torso, printed face, and a helmet. Helmet feels kind of loose on his head. And of course, all of these are made out of Chinese plastic. But his face is nice. Next, I opened the geisha, Japanese geisha, proficient in the art of pleasure. It has back printing, a little fan, and I give you some more facts about the geisha, but I don't think that's appropriate. Very nice, and also has printed hair. I really like this figure a lot. Next, I opened up the Rocker. Another really nice figure because he has a nice like play on Guns N' Roses for his shirt. No back printing. A brand new guitar printed. New face. A new mohawk design. It's a nice rubbery feel. And it fits on like that. And guitars like that. It's printed legs too. So he's cool. Next, I opened up the Painter. He's not really the one I wanted the most, but he's okay. Yeah, he's kind of he's okay. He's cool enough, but I just don't see a lot of uses for him. Finally, I got the Surfer Girl. Nice to have another female Lego City figure. Her face, I think it's new, but I don't know. The hair is new color. And her surfboard is very nice. And I'll show you the other figures in the series. The Underpant Gnome. I really wanted the Underpant Gnome. I mean, I really, really wanted that guy, but I didn't get him. I'll have to get him some other time. The Geisha. The Musketeer. I guess I only need 3 of those. The Rocker. The Surfer Girl I have. That guy I have. Frankenstein Monster I really need. He's also their Lego's bio for him is he's supposed to be really friendly. Instead of throwing girls in the pond, he actually helps girls learn to swim or something stupid like that. The hockey player, I really want him because he reminds me of my grandfather. The hockey player, I mean not the hockey, the new skater guy, he's cool. The sailor is cool. Soccer dude, I only want one of him. Wolfman I got. Hazmat dude, he's supposed to be really rare. I mean, rare. I want him. I don't want her. That's the only one I do not want. She just looks stupid. And he's supposed to be the rarest one of all the evil scientists. So look out for him. If you have him, he'll probably command a high price on Bricklink one day. And the packaging is this nice bright orange color. Hard not to miss. Series 3 had stupid puke green color. And Series 3 just sucked. I just hate Series 3. And I only have 3 figures from there except for stupid duplicates. Urgh. But Series 4 is awesome. Series 1 and 2 is awesome. So I hope you enjoyed this review. Please rate, comments, plus like, comment, subscribe, and see you later. Bye.